jumped in the river, what did I see? Black-eyed angels swam with me. A moon full of stars and astro cars. And all the figures I used to see. All my lovers were there with me. Past and future, and we all went to heaven in a little rowboat. There was nothing to fear, nothing to doubt.
Tired world, catching up with our tired lives. We let it out, pass by, without a trace to find our way back to the start. The soldiers are waiting on the other side. The soldiers are waiting for me.
Het is de eerste keer vandaag, maar ik ben het woord een beetje kwijt. Ik heb kippenvel. In het Engels dan. Ja, we proppen ons er even tussen. Ik kan daartussen gaan staan, of wat? Tussen die beesten. Ja, wat jullie net hebben... English modus. Okay, what you've just heard was Box. It's a... And... Yeah. Okay. Good. You're too precious to me, so please step a bit forward so you don't fall off the stairs. Next to me stands initiator Pieter Vandeveire. Okay, Pieter, I'm confused. What did I just hear? I heard a pop song, and I saw a theorb, so I'm quite confused.
Theorbo, that is.
Theorbo, sorry.
No, I guess you heard a bunch of colors that come from Baroque and Renaissance era, which for some years now, let's say 40 years, like have been reinvented and brought back alive because they were forgotten, they weren't used anymore, replaced, if you like. And a lot of people are working to revive this, and we wouldn't be here, of course, if all those people didn't, you know, go through all that trouble. Mm-hmm. But the thing is, today, it's to my opinion, it is useless, although I do a lot of Baroque music, mm-hmm. but it is useless to only use these beautiful colors, these beautiful instruments, like only in some sort of reconstructed 17th century time frame like nowadays. Mm-hmm. I mean, they're instruments. They should be used like the word instrument says, so that's what we try to do.
So that's why you make a musical fusion between pop and early music revivals.
Well, like I said, it is to give these colors a new meaning, mm-hmm. and it's also a personal thing. I mean, I spent a lot of time, like a lot of Baroque musicians, to learn these instruments and mm-hmm. to learn about how it was played. And I will keep on doing that for the rest of my life, I believe. But this is also something that I believe is worth doing, to use it again, if you like.
Now, Box is an artist collective. Mm-hmm. What kind of musicians do you need, do you use, do you want, what are you looking for?
I'm looking for people that are actually like not too much into just one thing.
Yes.
Like people that come from different backgrounds mm-hmm. and that have a lot of experience in different settings, and that love to experiment a little bit. And then it's true. It's not easy. It's not logical to find the right people to get this kind of thing going. And I was a little bit meticulous about asking.
How to work. Now, how do you choose your repertoire?
Sorry?
How do you choose your repertoire?
Well, actually...
It's quite British, isn't it? Okay.
How do I choose it? Well, to tell you the truth, this is the very first thing we did.
Oh.
And we did
so
it.
So it's a premiere.
Yeah.
Right. Cool.
Thanks. So we did it on a very short amount of time. So what I did was I picked like two artists that for me, even as a Baroque musicians, are like from when I was a lot younger, that I loved, totally loved, and that gave me some energy, like mm-hmm. PJ Harvey and Radiohead, mm-hmm. some energy that I much later on really felt also when listening and playing, for example, Monteverdi, mm-hmm. because the Baroque pieces we put in there were like early 17th century pieces. And like you said, like Kippenvel, I don't know what's that in English.
Weet iemand het? Goosebumps. Goosebumps, yeah.
So that kind of thing I get from Radiohead or PJ, but from this kind of music as well. So I don't see why I couldn't mix those two. And I don't mean to do like totally put everything upside down, but it's just two things that I like and that I try to choose that go together. There's one nice story though about...
Short one, please.
Yeah, okay.
We
very
still
short.
Have to clean up your...
Okay,
oh,
I see.
God.
No, this, the piece right before the Radiohead piece that we did is actually from Orfeo by Monteverdi, mm-hmm. and it's actually situated, it's an opera, so there's a story. Mm-hmm. It's situated when the main character is standing at the Styx. And actually, that Styx, you know, that mythological river where the dead people are being ferried across, mm-hmm. is what I heard inspired Thom Yorke to write Pyramid Song. So there is some, and also musically, there is ways to make it match.
Yeah,
so.
Okay. What does the future hold for Box?
I hope many things, but like I said, this was the first thing, and we have a lot of plans.